Welcome back to our YouTube channel, guys. My name's Ardil, and welcome back to another Behind the Sound video. Today's video is a bit of an update video on the VW T5.1 behind me, talking a little bit more about soundproofing, the speakers, where they're gonna be located, and they're already partially in, and also a little bit more about the install. So let's get cracking. But before we do, make sure you've hit the subscribe button. We've also got the massive 10K subscriber giveaway, so make sure you've seen that video. Link is in the description below, guys. But let's get cracking. So doors are apart. We've basically fully soundproofed the doors, three-layer system. So we've got the back of the card here. Then we've got this central layer, which actually houses the actual speaker and some of the window regulator and stuff. Then we've got the back of the door card being done as well. So I want to talk to you about the actual speaker ring and speaker adapter here itself. So what we've got inside there, which you can't see the back of it, this is the Hertz Miele Legend speaker. As you can see, terminals are being soldered on, so they are kind of bulletproof. They're never gonna come off there. Then what we've got is this XT60 plug. So if the manufacturer or anyone going into the door needs to remove the speaker that's in here currently, what we're actually gonna be doing is having these XT60 plugs inside the door so they can have quick release connectors. As you can see, guys, you can't get them the wrong way around, so there's no way of damaging any of our equipment when doing so. So it's all thought about in the long run of actually a vehicle's health, basically. The window regulator might fail in 3-4 years time, 10 years time, whenever that is, whoever needs to go into that door to service it can easily do so. So we've not blocked off any grommets, as you can see, guys. Even the cable clips and stuff is all serviceable items are still accessible. So that's why we don't cover things like all these bolts and things like that. We work around it to allow for that to actually be retained. So that's actually the Hertz Miele Legend 7-inch woofer that is installed into here. What we've done to create this baffle, it's quite a cool bit of kit that we've designed. Basically, it's built out of MDF, but also built out of some fiberglass as well to basically mold this into place. So as you can see here, this little panel here is actually part of the factory system. So this little terminal is a weatherproof shield because these are what's called wet doors, where basically water comes through into doors and it can damage speakers and things like that. They have this protective case from factory, so it's actually a VW part. So we've actually reutilized that from factory. So this is an MDF baffle that takes it from the size from factory down to a 7-inch woofer, and then there's a central layer that this basically can spin within. Obviously it'll all be secured by the time we can put it back together, but this is just for demonstration purposes. Basically, it's protecting the speaker, and also we've actually painted it black, but also used fiberglass and different materials to basically make this whole panel completely watertight and sealed, protecting the speaker for the long run as well, which is really nice. We've run new cables into the door using connections grade wiring all the way throughout the whole install. We're also retaining the factory radio here, guys. So inside the system, you've got the factory radio, and inside the little pocket underneath the gear lever there, you've got the Audison DRC amplifier, which might be a little bit too dark there for you to see, but it is a really, really nice bit of kit. That basically controls sub-level and also controls DRC options for basically settings between A and B presets. Inside here, what you've also got is the 10-inch Audison Prima sub. So this is in a custom box that are built, and then we redo this panel here to basically relocate all of the modules and stuff underneath, but in a really nice stock manner. That's actually been all sprayed black to blend in then with the underneath of here. So this is a custom box. This is the 10-inch Audison Prima sub playing directly underneath the driver's seat. Then we're going to have the amp rack, which is going to be mounted on the passenger side there. So Steve's been building this and working on the vehicle. So as you can see here, guys, basically this is going to be sitting inside the platform like so. In essence, you've got two amplifiers. You've got the Forza 1D and then you've got the Forza 8.9, both Audison Prima amplifiers that basically in essence link into each other. The 8.9 is 8 channels of amplifications with 9 channels of processing power. Then you've got the 1D as the slave amplifier in essence, that's basically linked in via an RCA cable from a pre-out into the input stage of the pre-in on the Forza 1D. That's basically where that link cable comes from. So that's that lead there. Then we've got high level speaker cable as an input, and then we've also got output coming out from there as well. It's all going to be fused here, but also fused at the actual battery as well in the front. So we're going to run fresh cable, power cable from connections live directly to the battery as well, which is really nice. Basically, it's important that all this cable run is done incredibly neatly. As you can see, everything loomed together nice and neatly. So you've got 2 8-gauge power cables that are going to go directly into here, and then they'll be earthed underneath the seat safely as well. In terms of the solution, basically the reason why we're using these two amplifiers to create a full sound in the vehicle, you've got the 8.9, which is 8 channels of amplification. The way that's going to be configured is basically channels 1 and 2 are going to be running the Hertz Miele Legend tweeters in the A-pillars. 3 and 4 are going to be running directly to this 7-inch woofer down in the door. That's called bridge. So we're running about 260 watts per when we're bridging to that 7-inch woofer in the door. That's giving those load morbid bass into the actual speakers there. Channels 5 and 6 are running into the driver's side door, and again into that 7-inch woofer, again providing load more mid bass, so loads of power doubling up basically, running directly into there. However, normally it's 85 watts per channel, but when you double up, it does give you a hell of a lot more power when you bridge these amplifiers. So we've got channels 1, 2 are tweeters, 3, 4 is left front speaker, 5, 6 is driver's side, 7-inch driver. Then we obviously have rear speakers going in, which is the Hertz Miele Pro range. They are going to be going on, running off the 7th and 8th channel, creating those full 8 channels of amplification running off this. So even though we've only got 6 actual components in the car, we are running full 8 channels of amplification, running the system completely fully active. Then we've got the 1 channel amp running directly to the sub. If that has confused you guys, make sure you book an audio consultation with me. I'll go through it in a lot more detail. I'll draw you out a picture and go through exactly how we spec a system and the advantages of going through a system like this. There are plenty of other options. We do hundreds of thousands of literally the endless opportunity of different systems for these types of vehicles. There's lots that can be done, there's lots that can be achieved, and we can do something for every type of budget. Obviously, these systems do take time to do. These are not a day job. These take a lot of time to do, to run all the cable neatly, but also safely as well. And also then after the whole install is actually done, it's very important that the setup's done. This has a processor, so it's got a DSP in it. That's the 8.9. The 9-bit is 9 channels of processing power. So we're using all 8 channels there and the 1 channel there, creating 9 channels of amplification in the system, running the 9 channels of processing power, allowing us to fully tune the system. And I'll be sitting in the vehicle customizing the system to the customer's songs. Basically, the customer emailed over earlier, I think a couple of days ago now, sent over a few songs, quite a few songs actually, of all his family members' favorite songs, and we're gonna be tuning the system to cope with absolutely everything. We're gonna have 2 presets on the system, one as a rear focus, as like a more of a family style, then we're gonna have a driver focus as well whenever our customer is driving by himself. But he's got the family in the vehicle, there'll be a full setup, filling out the car a lot more, giving you a little bit more variety in kind of the music taste that's actually gonna be going into the system. But it's going to be an absolutely awesome system. The boys are cracking on really, really well. The install's going very neatly behind the scenes, and I'm really happy with everything, how it's going so far. So we've got plenty more to crack on with, so there will be more videos later on showcasing a little bit more about the install, plus also the final video of the full system, all complete, exactly what it looks like to you guys as a customer. However, these videos are to showcase what actually goes on behind the scenes and getting a system up to where we get them every single time. So thank you very much for watching, guys. Make sure you've hit the subscribe button so you don't miss another one of our videos. But otherwise, thank you very much for watching. We'll see you soon.